You're just going bigger and better with each new debt, aren't you? Leave me alone. Can I help it if I got tired of dying the usual ways? But I'll say this, it was a debt any detective could be proud of. Huh? What makes you say that? The way you save somebody else before dying yourself. Oh, that waitress. The one with the chicken on her head. The next time you put a chicken on your head, you should try on about the size of the waitress. Oh. Really? I make a note of that for next time. But anyway, if you hadn't tried to save that waitress, you'd still be alive. You can't help it, you know, the detective thing and all. I wasn't able to save that poor van driver, though. At that speed, he must have died instantly. Well, we can't let a heroic detective like you stay dead. The root of this whole disaster is clear. The only question is, how do I stop it? Okay, let's get started. So I can't do anything with this. If you're going to call me anything, at least try to make it my name Sissel. Sorry about that, I'm real bad with names. Actually, I can relate to that. I'm better at remembering faces than names. So anyway, the future of this lady's career as a detective looks pretty bleak. You wrote this note, right? I think so, but I don't remember. 10 o'clock, that means it's already time for your meeting with whoever it was. Now that think about it, where you were supposed to meet might already be here. You're the detective, shouldn't you have checked that when you got here? Oh yeah, sorry, the chicken at this restaurant is really good. So you know. No, I don't know. Maybe you should take a look around the rest of the restaurant. Yeah, what's this? It's no use. I can't read what it says. Lizzie. Oh, hey. Now I remember what the sign says. If you would like some water, please ring the bell 3 times. 3 times? Yeah, the waiter doesn't bring any water if you only ring the bell once. She said those are the rules, apparently. I said, apparently? What do you mean, apparently? Don't you work here? Quite a stickler for the details, this detective. You want more water? Oh, sorry, I didn't ring the bell. It was with the more water bit. Oh well, come on, this is your 3rd glass. Okay, I get it, this is... Oh, wait, hold on. Okay, I get it. This was a little dig, wasn't it? Kind of like, hey, where's my food, right? No, not at all. Besides, I didn't ring it. But I would like to see you bring me my chicken soon. Duly noted. In the meantime, enjoy a nice glass of water. Yeah, I'm gonna hitch a ride here. Nope. Here you go. Can't reach anything. This is one big trunk. It seems pretty heavy too. It's very suspicious and red. Hey, let's see what's in it. Sorry, but that's not possible. It's locked. Darn, I wanted to see what's inside. Yeah, and I want to listen to this conversation. So what do you think, my dear beauty? Do you really think we can trust this steel? Who knows? It's not our job to think about that. But this incident did happen in this country, just as he predicted. Yes, and they were pretty amusing too, weren't they? The fellow who sang out the national security secrets during a live TV broadcast. And the man who they say to the Metro Police Department, taking the top dog hostage. But what if he double-crossed us? It wouldn't be pretty. No, he need this deal too. And we accepted all his conditions as well. Yes, and thanks to that, we have to be here on this extra little assignment. But as long as I'm paired up with you, beauty, I don't mind. How do they know about the cases at this special prison? Special prison? The guy who sang national secrets, the man who held C2 Metro Police. These cases are classified information. I heard about both of those cases and recently too. The preparations in those cases are being held at a special facility. That's what the special prison is, but it's not known about by the general public. So prisoner D99, Detective Yod, is one of those special cases too, huh? These two are talking about the very same cases I heard about yesterday. That couldn't be just a coincidence, could it? New information's been added. What is it, beauty? Why don't we move to a different spot? The table in the back looks good. Now you're talking, beauty, my dear. Just what I've been waiting for. A quiet, scared, secluded spot. Just the two of us. I wouldn't object to that. All of a sudden, I get this feeling somebody is eavesdropping. My sixth sense is very strong, you know? Yeah, that would be me. That's alright, my dear. You don't have to make excuses. Off we go across the bridge of Poultry to the land of love. What just happened? Did she sense we were here? What with her sixth sense? Haha. But you know, I have some pretty amazing powers myself. Yeah, like what? Like if there's a chicken nearby, I can tell right away. That's called a sense of smell. But anyway, at least the situation has changed a little bit now. Oh, really? I don't believe in a sixth sense, it's not scientific, says the ghost. But come to think of it, we've been left behind, haven't we? It looks that way. Not having legs is even more inconvenient than I thought it would be. But what are we going to do now? They're all their way over there. I'm telling you, we better shake a leg or we're going to miss what they're saying. I still don't see how this affects the car driver, but sure, whatever. It would be pretty hard to shake a leg, not having legs and all. They're still talking about something. I want to hear. Me too. Yeah, and I need to be close by. Let's see. No, can't do anything with the glass. Dispense. Actually, I'm just gonna see what this thing does. Okay. So I was wondering, we're not stuck over here by any chance, are we? We just might be. Okay, well, I had two thoughts. Number one, if you want to get over there where those two are, we have to use this red trunk they forgot somehow. Sounds about right. What's your other thought? It doesn't look like this blue-haired bartender is going to be much help. So I guess we have to find somebody who can help them. Oh, okay, that's why I'm stuck over here. If we have the fate change. And we can move over here, and then this one. I just need to do that once this time around. Oops. Wrong button. You rang? Oh, I get it. You saw that couple over there and you started to get lonely, right? And so you decided to call me. Oh, that's so sweet. Forgive me. But anything for anybody. What? Now could you not stand in my light, please? I can't see my glass properly. I've been working here for 2 days and I've been waiting this whole time for you to notice me. Now would you stop trying to shake me up and just stick to shaky cocktails? Ah, shit. She has a surprisingly short career with this place. Let's try this again. Sweet, I need to rewind. We're gonna do this. Oh, you just broke the glass, just like you did my heart. A broken glass can never be put back the way it was, just leave it there. You can't just leave it, somebody might get hurt. Does this trunk belong to the couple over there? Yes, yes it does. The only thing we allow customers to lose here are their careers. Miss, please go and let them know about the trunk, if you will be so kind. How gallant of you. I just might fall for you, you know. I think she already did. Odd girl. I agree. Me too. Now the question is, how do I reach that thing? Eh. Damn it. Oh, that makes sense. Thank you. Goodbye. I've been working for 2 days and I had my eye on you the whole time. I think this might be my last night working here too. It's been fun. I guess she's leaving this place with her surprisingly short career intact. Okay. I was wondering for a bit. Of all the things to forget, it wouldn't have been pretty if I forgot this. Here we are, finally. I feel kind of bad about eavesdropping though. Not me. I mean, we just delivered their last trunk to them after all. They own us at least that much. What kind of detective say something like that? Yeah. And I still don't see how this affected driver. Let's see, up there. Hello. Yeah, there we go. I can't believe I forgot the trunk of all things. With such a small body, you probably only have a small brain to match. Ouch, that hurt, beauty. But that's okay. That's what I love about you. That's what he loves about her? I don't get it either. Hold on. Yeah, water's good. So, now where were we? Alright. Who to invite to the wedding? If we got married, that is, of course. We can talk about that when we're alone. But aren't we alone now, beauty? Huh? Do you think she senses our presence again? I spy a ladybug. A ladybug? I just hate little bugs. I get it. But after all that trouble, it happened anyway? It looks that way, yes. It's not over yet though. It's not. What are you talking about? You're not dead yet. No, but I'm going to be in just a few seconds. But before that happens, maybe there's something we can do from here. Come on. Oh. Chicken as well. The trunk, so I don't think that's any. Can't reach it. There we go. Yeah. Hello, looks like he's unconscious. Excuse me, could you wake up for a second, please? Push as ever, this detective. One thing I've learned is that the newly dead stay unconscious for a little while at first. Huh? I was like that and you were like that too. Oh yeah, I guess you're right. Anyway, if we restart the flow of time now,